The story of Kurumi is one that draws tears from the eyes of people who feel pity for a man who stood firm for tradition. There was a time in the history of Yoruba where the heir to the throne is killed whenever the king dies. This tradition came about because it was discovered that a lot of princes killed their fathers so they could ascend the throne and become king instead. It was believed that if the heirs were killed alongside their fathers, kings would live longer on the throne. During this period, Alifin Adaba was the paramount ruler of the Oyo Empire, and he appointed Kurumi, the son of Ezeal, as the Aronika Konfo, the generalissimo of the whole Yoruba warriors. As it was with tradition, a king and an Aronika Konfo cannot stay in the same town because they wield similar powers, so Kurumi was assigned to Ije, where he was given the power to lord over. One day, Alifin Adaba summoned the kings and lords of the neighboring towns and told them he wished to change tradition. Present at the meeting were kings like the Timi of Eid, Balogun Ibikunal of Abadan, and Kurumi himself. When they were seated, Adaba came down from his throne and held the sword of Ogun, the Yoruba god of iron, in his right hand, and the bolt of Sango, the Yoruba god of lightning and thunder, in his left. He charged the royalties present to swear by the sword and bolt that after his death, his son Arimo Adalu will be made king after his demise. Kurumi disagreed immediately, and he reminded Alifin Adaba that according to the tradition, the moment Adaba does, his son Adalu must follow suit. Other royalties tried to persuade Kurumi, but he was adamant. When he couldn't convince them, he walked out in anger and headed for Ije. The other kings and chiefs went home to their people to inform them of the latest developments. When Balogun Ibikunal of Abadan told his chiefs the news, one of the chiefs Basaran Ogunmola took the matter up and suggested they wage war against Kurumi. Kurumi had once captured Ogunmola, who had a secret affair with his wife. He captured him, tied him to a stake like a goat and fed him ashes as food. As a form of revenge, Ogunmola proposed war against Kurumi. Alifin Adaba sent emissaries to Kurumi to change his mind, but he remained adamant, and when Alifin Adaba saw that he would not change his mind, he sent two calabash bowls to Kurumi. One of the calabashes contained an effigy of a pair of twins, Yoruba symbol of peace, while the other calabash contained gunpowder, Yoruba symbol of war. Kurumi immediately chose war and sent the emissaries back to Adaba. Immediately, Kurumi summoned his chief warrior Balogun Ogunkoroju and told him to prepare for war. As part of the preparations for war, Kurumi consulted the oracle, and the oracle warned him not to go to war with Abadan because he would lose the war. Kurumi was not going to have any of it, and he pestered the oracle to tell him what to do to win the war. The oracle then told Kurumi that in order for him not to lose the war, he must not cross the river Os, which was the boundary between Ije and Abadan. Kurumi agreed, and went ahead to plan for the war against Abadan. While Kurumi was making preparations, the Abadan warriors, led by Ogunmola, went to meet the people of Egba, who were said to possess very powerful charms. The Egba people then prepared a potent charm called Idi, a charm that causes someone or a group of people to ignore warnings or dare something that will harm them. The Idi was set out to the river Os so that the Ije warriors will be tempted to cross the river. When the war came, Kurumi sent his five sons to war to fight the Abadan people. During the face-off, Ije warriors soundly defeated the Abadan warriors, and the remaining Abadan warriors fled back, crossing the river Os. Unfortunately for Kurumi, his warriors fell to the potency of the Idi, and they crossed the river Os, believing that they had momentum, and that they could chase the Abadan soldiers far away. Immediately they crossed the river, their charms failed them, and they were killed in thousands by the warriors of Abadan who had set a trap for them. Kurumi suffered heavy losses, and lost all his five sons in the war. Basaran Ogunmola mocked him and sent a message to him that he was coming for his head. On hearing the news of the death of his sons and his men, Kurumi became very devastated and suicidal, but while he grieved, he held on to his belief that tradition remains tradition, and that he does not regret standing firm in the face of corruption. Kurumi committed suicide by taking poison, and he was thrown into the river Os according to his wishes so that Basaran Ogunmola won't have the luxury of cutting his head and hanging it in shame. If you enjoyed watching the video, then please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click on the notification icon so you don't miss out on an update.